edge?
No, I mean, what do you mean by that?
Oh, like for interviews today?
I guess they have me, like, with 4 15-minute ones back
yeah.
to back, and I guess they're all in different rooms, kind of just figuring it out as I go.
Yeah.
My freaking eyes are just, oh!
I slept with my contacts in last night, which I know you're not supposed to do, but sometimes, like, I just was tired, and I could feel myself falling asleep, and I was like, girl, if you don't get up now to take them out, you're going to fall asleep with your whole makeup and all your contacts, and I just did it, and then I woke up at, like, 6, and I was like, all right, let me just take them out for a couple hours.
Yeah, you know, some people, though, they're just not, you know, not sensitive to all that. Like, some people, and I know, they'll keep them in for a few days and then take them out. But me, I remember one time I fell asleep in the middle of a movie. You know, the movie Inception was so fucking boring.
Inception? Was boring?
I woke up and then my contact had like folded on top of it, so it was really weird. It's something weird in my eye.
Inside your eye.
But just that though, the next day, my eye was all swollen. I got this infection in my eye. I had to go to the doctor and then it spread to the other eye. Oh, we're just falling asleep in a movie. I'm like, oh.
That's
the most sensitive eye. They're so.
That makes me so mad. My boyfriend sleeps in his contacts every single night and nothing.
Yeah.
He must have weirdly strong eyes because he sleeps in them all the time and
just
nothing.
Don't have sensitive eyes.
Nothing really happens. I'm like, fuck you. And I'm like, you're going to get like a ripped cornea and then nothing ever happens to him.
Yeah.
But me, I sleep in them once and then I like wake up with pink eye. I'm like, great. Because the makeup, like, gets up in there.
Yes, that is me. I can't, those sensitive eyes. They're a blessing and a curse. Everyone's like, get those amazing eyes.
Give
me some shit.
Yeah. Okay, that's good. I love this. This is like, it feels almost like a condom. No, it doesn't. Okay, hi, Brittany Amber.
Oh, we're already going hi.
I'm going to, I just like roll it and then I cut around it.
Oh, okay.
How does this shot look? This looks okay. Oh, should I take off my badge? We know you're legit. Brittany Amber, is this your first AVN Awards?
No, this is my 11th.
My God, 11? Yes. You don't look like
you've been doing
porn for 11
years.
Yes,
I've actually been doing porn for over 12 years. I got in the business right before the AVN of that year. And because I got in the business of December of 2007, so then January was calling me up, and everyone was like, oh, are you going to AVN? And I was like, what is that? Maybe not, you know, because I was just so new. And that was actually probably would have been a good thing to go network and stuff like that. But I was just like, felt so new that I'm like, oh, I don't know anything about that. I'm just, this is my 11th now.
Wow. What are you, I don't have my card in front of me because I'm so professional. What are, remind me again, what are you nominated for?
So this year I am nominated for MILF Performer of the Year.
Ooh.
I'm officially a MILF now. I was also nominated for that for X-Biz as well. So that was my first year ever being nominated as a MILF.
Is this your first MILF year?
Yes, I know. And then I'm also nominated for a mainstream venture of the year. I did a mainstream movie called Girls, Guns, and Blood. So that is
so exciting
because that's such an awesome movie. It's a very campy kind of like Quentin Tarantino style movie. And it's really funny and it's got a lot of action and boobs and everything. It's got everything. It is such
everything
a fucking awesome movie. And now if you have Amazon Prime, you can watch it for free.
Wow.
So, yeah, everybody
check
watch it,
out,
it there.
There's
yeah,
no
I know everybody's
reason.
Got Amazon Prime. So.
Everyone has Amazon Prime.
Yes.
So you like Quentin Tarantino. Did you see Once Upon a Time in Hollywood?
I didn't see that. I like the older movies. I don't know. I didn't even
Kill
see
Bill.
That Crazy 8 one or whatever that one was.
Oh, yeah, the
Kill Bill's amazing movie. Yes.
Was it the Crazy Eight or like
It wasn't called Crazy. It was something Eight, the Hateful Eight
the
or
Hateful
something.
Hateful Eight.
Yeah, like Crazy Eight, whatever. I never even watched that movie because my sister, she actually manages a theater back at home, and so she watches all the movies early, you know, and spoils everything for me. Like, even, you know, she'll just get right to it. Remember when, you know, that Rogue One movie came out? Everyone dies at the end, you know, it's whatever. I'm just like, well, why am I even going to watch it now? But she does that with everything. And so she did that kind of with that. She was like, I forgot what she said about it. Actually, now I forgot now. Maybe I can watch it. But I think she said something along the same lines. I think everybody dies in that movie or something, right? Or
are you a Star Wars fan?
I sorta am. Star Wars is cool, but my daughter though is a super Star
Wars daughter?
Fan.
Oh
yes, I do. I do.
How old is she?
She's gonna be 15 this year.
No, yes. Effing. No, we
you
can
told
say
you
fuck.
I'm a legit MILF. Yes,
that's what I was wondering. I'm like, do you necessarily have to have a kid to be in to do MILF porn? But of course not.
But yeah. See, that's the thing. There is this huge, like, it's such a misterm in our industry because MILF means mom, I'd like to fuck. Yeah. It doesn't mean, like, there should be cougars, right?
Yeah, like, woman who's old enough to have a daughter that I like to fuck, I guess
yeah,
that's
it's
too
cougars,
long.
Right? It hasn't yeah. always been the term, but how did it get shifted into MILF?
Like, I wonder if cougar seems too, like, if it seems too old to people.
I don't know. I don't think so, because cougar just means an older woman with a younger man.
Yeah, who has, like, prowling.
It could even be just, yeah, a few years older than her man. You yeah. know, it doesn't even have to be that much. So, yeah, I don't know where this... Maybe it just, like, sounded cooler or something. I don't know.
Maybe it's just easier to type it in, because you're just like, oh, MILF. Like, cause.
That, too, because, yeah, that's what I've noticed, too. That's another reason why I've been pushing, into the MILF category early, because if you're not a keyword, it's really hard to get searched and get booked and things like that, because a lot of times when you're getting booked from your agent, they'll be like, oh, I need a teen, I need a MILF or whatever. There's nothing really in between, so that's when people kind of have a lull in their career there, and that's what usually kicks a lot of people out or into doing other things. And but I don't know, I was able to stick through it, and now I'm a MILF, now officially. And there's still even people now that are like, you're a MILF. Like, I get those comments still all the time. But
they still see you a certain way. They see you, like, as not a MILF.
Yeah, I guess. I mean, yeah, and that's another reason, too, or that misterm is so annoying, because I'm in my 30s, and I have a teenage daughter in high school. I'm the definition of a MILF, so why are you guys not accepting me as that? Now I'm nominated for AVN and XFIZ MILF Performer of the Year, so now I'm, like, officially a MILF now.
Girl, I hope you win. One time before I was even doing this show and, like, learning more about porn, one time, I think it was, like, one of my fans was like, yo, you look like that, you look like this porn star, and then they actually put a picture of you, and, like, that's how I first, and first of all, like, compliment of my life, like, you're stunning, but then I was like, oh, and then it turns out, like, that I was interviewing you, I'm like, oh, this is so cool.
Oh, great, yeah.
She's like, you don't look at all like me. Oh, this is what I was wondering, so you have a 15-year-old daughter, does she know what you do?
Yeah, she does. We actually just kind of talked about this recently. She had, some weird stuff happen at school with some kids Googling things and
the kids. See, when we were young, like, I'm your age, like, when we didn't have the fucking internet, like, when we were 15 and, like, we weren't, like, we would be not Googling stuff. Like, we would just be, like, out playing, but we couldn't.
It's so much harder in this age for all of this for, a kid if you're growing up that way, I guess, But it's funny, I was just on Holly Randall's podcast, and, her mom, Suze Randall, and she grew up as a child and, with a parents in the adult industry. And so we're kind of talking about that, comparing stories. And so I was kind of curious, too, because back then when she was in school, same thing, she didn't have internet of all that. But she said one time a kid had came to school with a Penthouse magazine that had her mom's name in it and thought it was her mom because it said Suze Randall, but her mom's a photographer.
Oh,
so there's a whole thing at school.
God.
Her mom had to come down to the school and everything. So, yeah, she could relate a lot with my daughter when we're comparing stories. I'm like, oh, yeah, I never really thought about it that way.
Some other kid in your daughter's class Googled and found you.
Yes, and then they're obviously kids talk. They tell one kid, and then they're walking around the phone like, "Is this your mom?" And so this is, I'm sure, an unprecedented thing for the school. I would go through all the stuff, talking to all these, talk to two different vice principals and everything, and everybody, everyone that I talked to was like, "Oh, your daughter is so mature, and she's like, you can tell she's raised so well. She's such a good kid."
Oh,
and all
that
this
must
stuff.
Feel good to hear.
Yeah, it was. It was like, oh, even not for nothing. Like, even just getting all these, I'm like, oh wow, it kind of highlighted all this stuff to me, and I'm like, oh wow. But they were even talking about, this girl in particular. They're like, we kind of see that she has, like, some kind of troubles going on at home. They're gonna have the parents come in and everything. She seems
the other
like
girl.
A troubled child.
Okay.
Yeah. And so they could see, and the school, they're so, they didn't bring up anything about, what I do for a living. That was not an issue at all. I mean, obviously this is, like, a legit job, and so you always kind of get worried about that too, just everyone's perception of everything, just that it's because they don't understand it. I'm sure they don't know anybody in the industry or anything like that, so it's really hard to make up your own mind about things. But they were so on our side, and they were just kept complimenting me and my parenting skills and how great my daughter has turned out. I was like, oh,
that's amazing. So it was another girl in her class who was like Googling and found you, and then she said to your daughter, what, like, is this your mom? Like,
just yeah. And I, you know, it's funny too, it's like, I never, unless I'm working, I never wear makeup or anything like that. And I don't know how she even really put two together, but you know, kids, oh my God. And the thing is too, is kids, especially teenagers, they're online looking at, they have way more time than we all do to do all this shit. So it kind of does make sense in that, when you think about it with that logic, it's just like, damn. But you know, kind of glad, you know, the Band-Aid's been ripped off. She hasn't had any problems since, you know, it's, so, and actually too, after all that happened, there's a few other kids, you know, that she didn't even know, but like came to her defense, and they were like, oh, like one of the little boys that was like, oh, it's just your mom. It was his girlfriend that came and was like, oh, I told him that that's messed up and not to do that and all this stuff. So there's a lot of kids coming to her defense.
Good.
She hasn't had any problems since. So yeah, that, I mean, I knew that, you know, it was coming, you know, but I'm glad the Band-Aid's been ripped off. We've gotten all that now.
And I'm sure that was, like, giving you a lot of anxiety. Like, in the back of your head, you're like, okay, I know this is, like, one day is coming, because you're, like, you're probably thinking, like, well, I don't want to tell her, like, too soon, you know?
Yes, exactly.
Like, my boyfriend has a 9-year-old son. I don't even, he still believes in Santa. So it's, like, everybody's different, like, what to tell your kid. And it's hard. And, like, I would worry, like, you know, and it was like, it doesn't sound like the principal or the vice principal like judged you or like gave you shit, which is like, actually, really cool.
Yeah, judged me in a good way. They were, all they really did was compliment me and my daughter. So I was just like, oh wow, I'm really happy that this is the way that they perceived everything. But what was I gonna say?
But you didn't feel judged by them, and they were complimenting your parenting. And
I was gonna say something else about something else though. Shit, where was I going?
The other girl who found you because they were Googling. They have too much time on their hands. You don't wear makeup unless you're working. Oh, you mean like they weren't judging you, but they were like positive, like. Were they, was like the president and the vice president, I imagine if they're dudes, they'd be like, did you detect any level of like, hey now, you know?
See, yeah, that's the thing too, is actually both of the vice principals both were women. So maybe that is part to do with it.
Cool.
I don't know. And I spoke with another lady too, and she was also a lady. So I didn't speak with one man about this. So yeah, maybe, I never really thought about that before, but maybe that is why I had a good experience.
Was this in LA?
No, I live in the desert of California, near Palm Springs.
That's awesome to know that. Because I could just imagine, like, I mean, I get judgment from my boss, like, from my day job that I do comedy. Like, literally anytime I call out sick, like, and he's old, he's like, he's like, oh, you really should stay out of the clubs and just, like, go home after work, which is wild because it's, like, people can be sick. I mean, I wasn't really sick. I'm just, like, doing gigs and stuff. But that's cool to hear that they were so nice about it. What if your daughter in like a couple years came to you and was like, Mom, I want to do porn?
Well, I mean, obviously I couldn't judge, but the thing is my daughter is like a very like nerdy, techie person, and she's already looking into tech colleges and stuff. And she doesn't she's also very uncomfortable with anything like any PDA or anything like that. It almost makes her want to barf. Like, she can't even stand it. And I also kind of see her kind of on, like, it's a whole other long story that I will get into later, but there's been many signs of kind of like she's very interested in the asexual community and all of
these. Interesting.
And I guess there's like this furry asexual community that she was like talking to me about, all this different stuff. So I'm like, I haven't really pried on that with her yet. Kids are still figuring themselves out, but my daughter is, to make a long story short, very not sexual at all.
Wow.
It makes her very uncomfortable. And the thing is too, is like, she said that she had known for a while, even before this, and you know, because she's always
before
online.
She found out.
And I also have a YouTube channel, and so she's also, one time, it was a while ago, and she was like, I took her to the Queen Mary, and I kind of did some YouTube stuff there on the side, and so she was like, oh, I went to your YouTube channel to find that video, but I didn't look at anything else, or, I don't have anything that
so
bad.
Sweet.
Yeah, and so that was the thing, too, is that when she found out, because, you know, after we had all this conversation, and I'm like, well, how long did you know, and she was just like, well, you know, for a while, and I'm like, well, why didn't you talk to me about it, you know, and I'm like, she was like, well, you know, I didn't want to make you mad. And I'm like, why would that make me mad? Like, we need to talk about. And here's the thing, too, is like, oh, I just remember what I was going to say, though. you know, I really wish I know that it's like a fine line, like too young to understand all this kind of stuff. But like, you know, I wish I would have talked to her, you know, years ago, because then she would have been able to navigate this better when it did happen. You know, she would have known how to respond and like what to tell the kids rather than being shocked and being like, I don't know what to do. You know, so that's why I feel so bad that I didn't.
Be prepared and like, oh, yeah, maybe like respond from a place of like answering them and not like maybe feeling her own surprise.
Yeah. Or I mean, she could have just been like, no, it's not. And then just move, like kept it moving or something, and just like, you know, just brushed it off, kept brushing off, and you know, because it's like, how else would they really confirm that unless she was, you know, did the reaction she did? So I don't know, like I still feel really bad about that. Is anybody watching that? Issue? No. Which is, I know this is like a one in a billion issue, but
it's what makes you
talk
really,
to them early. Gosh,
it's what makes you really interesting, and I like really respect. Like, it sounds like you're a really good parent.
Well, thank you so much.
It's like, and like clearly the people in your school, like her school, are echoing that. Mm-hmm. Do you know if she's sexually active at all? Like,
no, she's not.
Oh, right, because asexual, right?
Yeah, she's absolutely not.
Do you ever wonder if that's like a response to like, oh, like, I don't want to do what mommy does?
Well, yeah, I don't know. I kind of thought about that too, because, you know, for example, my sister's boyfriend, his parent or his dad, you know, is an alcoholic, and he'll like never touch alcohol, you know, like those kind of things, you know. Maybe that's how it is. I don't know. Yeah, it could be, but I don't know. I always think, even besides that, like I just got so lucky with her that she's not. And here's the thing too, she's so much like her dad. And I guess her, you know, her dad was telling me too that he had no at all sexual interest until he was 18. And so,
wow, for a guy that seems so rare, because aren't most guys like, you know,